there was the Wednesday night, we sailed, and then there was the vessel sunk on the Monday morning at 2:20, not before nights.
When did you know something was wrong?
When I was really in the lifeboat and I actually saw the thing up sort of turn on its end and go down. I think that would be the first time. This is what I think now.
Where were you when the Titanic hit the iceberg?
I was sound asleep. Yes, sound asleep. Well, the little boy woke me up. You see, yeah. I was wakened twice, apparently. The little boy woke me up, but I promptly went to sleep. He turned, opened the door, switched on the light.
Right.
And said, all up topside. I remember that. Him saying that. But I took no notice of all up topside. It didn't mean anything to me at all. I don't remember going to sleep again, but apparently I did, because the matron came and got me out of bed, you see.
Mr. Hall, when you got up to the deck, how many people were up there?
They seemed to be in groups, you know, as though nobody was doing anything. They were just standing in little circles talking, you see. They were waiting for people to get in, but they wouldn't get in.
Why wouldn't they get in?
I think what I heard afterwards, there were remarks such as, you know, too cold, and they were safe from where they were, that sort of thing. See, they hadn't gone to tilt at that stage, and I must also remark that the sea was perfectly still and calm, which was just as well. Had it not been so, well, I wouldn't have been here now. Well, the boat struck at 11:40, you see. Well, of course, nothing happened. We'll stay till 1:15. People didn't begin to get a little bit, because there was a little bit of a tilt, began to show. And then people began to I suppose, realise that they had to get into the lifeboats.
When people finally realised that something was wrong on the ship, what happened?
About 20 firemen came up from the stokehole, up what they call the fiddly. It's a kind of an escape place right up the bowels of the ship. They all came out. They had nothing on except trousers, and mm-hmm. They were all covered with sort of sweat. I thought they looked to me as though something had chased them out, as though the devil was after them, you see. Well, of course, what had happened was the stokehole that they were in had got flooded, you see. The water had come in over the top, and they'd shut up the fiddly, you see.
And they were
well,
terrified.
Then they, of course, was a disadvantage. They didn't know what was going on at all up top. We didn't know what was going on down below. It's just as well we didn't, probably, because it must have been hell down there, you know. Then the passengers began to think, well, they better get into the lifeboats too, I suppose. I was still standing there with my mouth open, just looking. You couldn't hear very much. It was this roar of steam and coming out, you see, because the boilers weren't working. They hadn't got them all pulled, you see. And they had to keep some of the boilers going for the light, to keep the lights going. And I may say the lights... And the lights kept going till almost the time the vessel foundered.
How did you get into the lifeboat?
I was pushed in.
They pushed you over the side?
In the end. This should be about half past one.
Keep back! Did you know where your mother was then?
I thought I saw her in the lifeboat. And just as I thought I saw her in the lifeboat that I was in, it was going over the side, it was full, it was filled at that time, but I thought she was in that lifeboat at the other end, you see. But anyway, when we boarded the Carpathia in the morning, finally the roll call was called, but she was not there, you see, so they must have thrown her out during the night. There were people thrown out of the lifeboats during the night because they had to make room for those that were on the life rafts, you see. They were just standing up altogether.
People were actually thrown out of the lifeboat.
If they were dead, yes.
Oh, right. Yeah. Were there a lot of people crying or upset like that?
Not at that stage. In the lifeboats and on the Carpathia in the morning. Yes. Oh, yes. Very sad there. That was the worst. I think that was the one I saw the worst of it myself. When I saw the tragedy of it there, because see, there were women looking for babies and children and everything. My husband's drowned, wife's drowned, all that, very sad.
Was that when you were looking for your mother, too?
Yes, oh, well, because they had a roll call, you see, but she was not there.
Do you think you were very lucky to survive?
Oh, yes. Oh, well, I do now, yes. Oh, yes, of course. Oh, yes. Well, I mean, you couldn't think of anything else, could you?
Thinking of the Titanic, and there, of course, is a piece of living history with William Hall being a survivor, one of the few.